I got my hands on one of Rivian's new AI self-driving computer chips, and I think it's time we learn for ourselves the truth about this universal hands-free system. This video is not sponsored. I did get to try out Rivian's new self-driving software during the recent AI day, and I have some thoughts. I do own my own Rivian truck, but it is a Generation 1 vehicle, and we're talking about Generation 3 hardware, which my truck does not have. Alas, it is always the shiniest rocks, which are ever so slightly outside of reach, unless there's something we can do with this. Rivian is calling this square of silicon the Gen 3 Autonomy Computer, powered by the RAP1 Rivian Autonomy Processor, and it's all designed and built in-house by Rivian themselves. This is the brains of the new Generation 3 hardware. And you might be like, hey Jerry, how did you get your hands on an unreleased one-of-a-kind computer chip? It's gotta be worth like $1 billion. And well, I don't have just one, I have two, which tracks because they are meant to be paired up in tandem to calculate the 1600 trillions of operations per second that are needed for autonomous driving. And for the record, I didn't actually steal these processors from the Rivian event. I asked real nicely first, and surprisingly, they said yes. You miss 100% of the shots you don't take. So huge thumbs up to Rivian for letting us see under the hood. It's extremely hard to mentally comprehend this level of computing power, especially in such a small package. 1600 trillion operations a second is a lot. For reference, the iPhone processor in your pocket has about 35 trillions. Apple's about to be knocking on Rivian's door. And Tesla's latest Hardware 4 full self-driving computer is estimated to be around 500. They also might come knocking soon as well. Rivian's 1600 trillions of operations per second pales of course in comparison to the DeLorean's 1.21 gigawatts. But operations per second isn't everything. The reason this autonomy processor is so special is because the processing unit here in the center can analyze 5 million camera pixels worth of information per millisecond, or 5 billion pixels per actual second. The 11 cameras, 5 radars, and LiDAR unit on the exterior of the R2 produces a lot of data that needs to be calculated and reacted to super fast.
So this is the original Gen 2 computer. You can see how big it is and how thick. This is the Gen 3, 50% smaller, yet 4 times more powerful, and it's got 2 of the Rivian chips installed inside of it. So these two processors will be flipped over with 2 cooling lines, liquid cooling, that flows into the module.
And normally in a desktop computer or gaming console, or even the previous second generation Rivian computer, the memory chips are positioned somewhere else on the motherboard, which means it takes a while for the information to travel to the processor. Rivian has taken these memory chips and placed them directly into the main brain, internalizing them to make the data transfer near instantaneous.
Okay, so the chips are off of this one and now it's just the board?
It's called the substrate. The board in the package is called the substrate usually.
With 3 independent LPDDR5 channels with 205 gigabytes per second of bandwidth, Rivian's chip communicates about 16,000 times faster than your home Wi-Fi. These chips are also designed to be linked together, so if Rivian finds out in the future that level 4 or 5 self-driving takes more than 1600 trillions of operations per second, they can just insert more of the same chips into the stack and they'll interconnect with what Rivian is calling RivLink, kind of future-proofing their hardware. And it's nice when Rivian makes all of the hardware and all of the software. Speaking of which, the Generation 3 hardware won't be coming out until the end of 2026, and it'll be in the new Rivian R2 vehicles. But what's coming sooner than that to the existing second-generation vehicles on the road today is the Autonomy Plus Universal Hands-Free Driving, which expands the potential usable driving area from around 150,000 miles of highways to 3.5 million miles of roads across the USA and Canada. Basically, any road with a painted line is now in play.
Did it do the blinker? Did you do the blinker?
It did the blinker.
During my test ride, it was kind of wild to see a Rivian performing turns, stopping at red lights, and driving around by itself on regular roads. Under human supervision, of course, since it's still very much a level 2 advanced driver assistance system. However, there was one moment when the vehicle didn't notice that there was a line of cars forming at a left-hand turn. So it tried to get into the turning lane a little too late, and left its booty hanging out in the through lane.
so the safety driver had to pull it a little closer to the car in front to edge out of the main lane as a courtesy thing. I've seen you human drivers do the same thing though, and since AI is trained on human behavior, it's probably one of y'all's fault that this happened in the first place. Tesla is really the only other company at the moment with a point-to-point level 2 system. There are a few level 5 driverless robotaxi companies out there, like Waymo and Zoosk, but RJ did say on stage that Rivian's hands-off and eyes-off software updates are coming in the future, which is epic. I think Generation 3 is going to be a game changer. Our second generation computer, though, did avoid bikers and people walking on the side of the road, and even slowed down for an approaching speed bump, which was convenient.
So we essentially mined for these cases. So we found other customers going through speed bumps, and then you see the slowdown.
And then you see the immediate pickup of speed after this speed.
When Rivian's Generation 3 hardware launches in 2026, it'll be the most powerful combination of sensors and inference available in all of North America, which is pretty impressive.
So they have this plexiglass model kind of showing where all the sensors are. So there's a total of 10 cameras, you know, vision cameras that are around the outside. There's also LiDAR up in the top, corner radar sensors, then a front imaging radar sensor as well, you know, with another camera down there. And that whole sensor suite is inside of this R2. So there's the LiDAR up in the top and this TV. The LiDAR can see it perfectly. So you can see my shadow as I wave my hand with the LiDAR screen. So this is real time what the car is seeing. Very cool. LiDAR doesn't have the same restrictions as vision cameras. So if there's a fog or something like that, or smoke that the car is driving through, or a bunch of rain, LiDAR wouldn't be impaired like vision cameras would be.
LiDAR didn't make a whole lot of sense, you know, 10 years ago, when the LiDAR cameras themselves cost tens of thousands of dollars, but now these LiDAR modules only cost hundreds of dollars, and can analyze more than 5 million individual points in a 3D space per second. LiDAR is able to function in bright light or low light, as well as in fog and in situations where vision-only cameras or even human eyeballs can't see. LiDAR can even work in complete and total darkness. No headlights required. The radar, LiDAR, and vision cameras can fact-check each other in real time, and Rivian has even installed it in a way that is relatively invisible on the R2. I'm a pretty big fan of LiDAR, and I personally think that having a LiDAR installed is the only path to levels 4 or 5 autonomy.
There's a lot of big promises mentioned on stage, but personally, I'm a big fan of where the future is headed. Tesla has been telling us that level 5 autonomy is coming next year for the past 10 years and is getting a little bit old. So personally, I'm excited to see a new player in the space with even more compute and even more sensors. Competition breeds innovation. Rivian's Autonomy Plus package is either a one-time fee of $2,500 or a monthly fee of $50, if it's even a service that you want in the first place. Let me know what you think down in the comments. I'm gonna see if there's a spot in my truck where I can plug this in. And thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.